Hello students, today we are going to read the first chapter of our EVS book. Chapter number 1, Everyone is Unique. Everyone is unique means everybody is special in their own way. So let's start the reading.
All grow with age. Growth is the process of increasing in size. It is because of our growth that our shoes become tight, our clothes do not fit us, or the length of our trousers becomes short. Measurement of height. The height of all human beings continues to increase up to 18 to 20 years of age. One day, a medical checkup was conducted in a class. Each student of the class started to argue about the tallest and the shortest student. Some students believed Sid to be the tallest among all, while the others argued that Jia was the tallest. To solve their conflict, a teacher came to their rescue and taught them how to measure height in a proper way to find out who is tall and who is short. Their teacher, Miss Annie, asked Sid to stand against the wall and she marked his height on the wall using a pencil and a ruler. Then, with the help of a measuring tape, she measured Sid's height. Sid measured 4 feet 4 inches. Similarly, she found Jia's height. Jia was 4 feet 2 inches tall. After doing this activity, Miss Annie told the entire class that the height is measured either in centimeters or in inches also. 1 foot is equal to 12 inches. 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeter. Appreciating family members. All family members of a family are different from each other. For example, a member of your family may be soft-spoken and quiet, while the other may be loud. Also, everyone in the family has some special quality. For example, someone may have a good handwriting, while the other may be good at painting and art, and others may be good at dancing, acting, or cooking. We must always appreciate the uniqueness and good qualities of our family members. It gives them the encouragement to do better in life. Serving infants. You must have observed a small baby in your family or neighborhood. A baby keeps crying most of the time. Do you know why? It is because they cannot talk and express themselves as we do. Only parents can understand whether the baby is crying because of hunger, pain, or wants to be cuddled. Babies express their happiness by laughing. our likes and dislikes. Every individual has different likes and dislikes. Your sibling may like to eat Indian food while you may like to eat Chinese. Your friend may like to eat chocolates, but you may like to eat ice creams. Our likes and dislikes greatly depend on the environment and the people surrounding us. That is our family and friends. For example, our food habits are often shaped by our family members and the region we live in to a great extent. Some people are vegetarian while others are non-vegetarian. Some people like the smell of fish, mustard oil, garlic, eggs, and love to eat them, while the others do not like that smell and do not eat them. Sensing things. Our sense organs, such as the eyes, nose, ears, tongue, and skin, help us to see, smell, hear, taste, and touch things respectively. The sense organs send information from the surroundings to our brain through nerves on feeling something. The body parts respond according to the orders of the brain. You have already studied in the previous classes that there are some people who are unable to use one or more of their body parts, but the other body parts function properly, and the other senses of such people become sharper. These people are called differently abled. Feeling to read. Blind people have a sharp sense of touch. It helps them to read using their hands on the braille script. The braille script enables the blind people to read. This script consists of patterns made of 1 to 6 raised dots that makes it possible for the blind people to read through touch. It was invented by Louis Braille, who himself was blind. In spite of the disabilities, there are many differently abled people who have made remarkable achievements. One of them is Helen Keller. Helen Keller was a very intelligent and sensitive woman. She lost her sense of sight and hearing when she was only 19 months old. Her teacher Annie Sullivan taught her to read and write with the help of Braille. Helen Keller went on to become a world famous teacher and author. Sensitivity towards differently abled. Most differently abled people are able to carry out their daily activities. However, we should help them in making their lives easier. Our government has also taken many initiatives to help them. For example, the National Channel telecast news for people who are deaf. Low floor buses by Delhi Transport Corporation DTC helps in easy boarding. Ramps are constructed at public places to help people who use wheelchairs, etc. We must be sensitive towards differently abled people and pay attention to their needs.